Bihar's House of Horrors and the rape of young girls here as young as seven. All this by in homes run by prominent journalist Brijesh Thakur, seem to be close to various politicians. For more, let's go across to Manish Kumar. Manish, and also adding to this is the picture which has come out today of Brijesh Thakur, the controversial journalist in police custody, where he's smiling, seems to be absolutely defiant. Is that because of his close political links? Tejaswi Yadav says he's close to Nitish Kumar, but what is the reality of it? Did the state government fail in cracking down on Brijesh Thakur because of his powerful political connections?
Sonia, what you are saying is partly correct and partly, it's far from the fact also. Because whatever Brijesh Thakur, did or flourished or whatever, his wrongdoings were, it was right under the nose of Nitish Kumar government also. But when he was caught, it was also the state government which ordered for the audit from the Tata Institute of Social Studies, because somewhere some officers in the state government who were in the minority for last over a year, they could smell that there was something rotten there, and despite their best efforts, they were not able to undercover or to expose this the whole nefarious activities which was going on inside that campus. But of course, yes, Brijesh Thakur still enjoys very good support from within the administration, and nobody knows it better than the Muzaffarpur police, which filed the charge sheet. In this case, Sonia, surprisingly, when the police paid for his police custody so that they can interrogate him, the court ordered, the local court ordered that no, you can go inside the jail and you interrogate him there, which, well, despite the local SP pleading in the court that he is not cooperating, the court refused to give his police remand so that they can take him out and they can interrogate him. Mm-hmm. But in this case, the local police now, which has handed over all the documents, all the evidences, they are saying that it's such a watertight case, nobody can save Brijesh. But every day, some new facts are tumbling out.
Of course.
It's all, signals to one fact, that because he had his contacts in the administration and the state government, that is why he was bagging one contract after another and nothing was happening to him.